Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here. Today I want to approach the topic in a storytelling format because, you know, I'm trying various approaches. It keeps things interesting for me. This is a difficult subject, HIV as such, so please indulge me. Later on, I'll have the same video in a question and answer format with Maha so that you'll have much better clarity. Today's topic is called TACK or Tack. Varying formats keeps the thing interesting for me, and I hope this works for you as well. That's it. Let's get started. Welcome back, friends. Today I'll tell you the story of TACK or Tack, which may potentially help rid of infected CD4 T cells. So this is an approach to get rid of HIV infected CD4 T cells. It all starts with the bustling halls of Merck's research facility. A group of scientists embarked on a daring quest. Their mission was to find a way to defeat HIV, a virus that has eluded a cure for decades. Among the team was Dr. Jane Collins, a brilliant virologist with a passion for innovation. Little did she know they were about to stumble upon something extraordinary, a breakthrough that could change the face of HIV treatment forever. The story begins with a well-known class of drugs called non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, or NNRTIs. These drugs have been long used to inhibit HIV's ability to replicate itself. But during the routine experiments, the team noticed something peculiar about certain NNRTIs, particularly efavirenz and rilpivirine. These drugs didn't just stop HIV from replicating, they seemed to cause the infected cells to self-destruct. And this intrigued Dr. Collins and her colleagues, and they started to dig deeper. They discovered that at a later stage in the viral life cycle, these NNRTIs cause the HIV-infected cells to produce viral proteins prematurely. One of these proteins was the HIV protease enzyme, which normally helps assemble new viruses, but when synthesized prematurely, the protease snipped apart vital cellular proteins instead of triggering a self-destruct mechanism known as inflammasome. The infected cells were essentially poisoned by their own viral machinery. The team dubbed these remarkable compounds as targeted activators of cell kill, or TACK. Unlike traditional therapies that relied heavily on the host's immune system, TACK drugs use the virus's own protein to destroy the infected cells, targeting only those cells that harbored HIV. This was a significant leap because HIV has always been a lifelong challenge as it hides its genetic instructions within a population of long-lived central memory cells, and these cells, part of the human immune system memory, can lie dormant for decades. And previous approaches aimed at eradicating these reservoir cells, they struggled because they couldn't differentiate between infected and healthy cells. Powerful treatments risk damaging the entire immune system itself, so it fell short. In their pursuit of a cure, the scientists had been experimenting with what we now know as shock and kill strategy. This involved waking up dormant HIV-infected cells so that they can be identified and seen by the human immune system and destroyed by the immune system or targeted therapies. However, this approach had seen limited success. The immune system couldn't always find and destroy all the reactivated cells, and treatments strong enough to kill infected cells often harmed healthy ones as well. TACK drugs, however, offer a new hope. They activated the infected cells and then used HIV's own proteins to ensure only those cells were destroyed which had HIV in them. In other words, if these TACK drugs went into healthy CD4 T cells, they wouldn't find the genes that are present only in HIV, and therefore they wouldn't create the proteins in the cell environment to make it self-destruct. So it was very, very specific. It was activating dormant HIV cells and then killing them. It was a precise and elegant solution, leveraging the virus's own life cycle to achieve the kill. The leading candidate among the compounds is one called as PYR01. This molecule not only inhibited HIV replication, but also excelled at inducing the premature synthesis of HIV proteins, leading to cell death. In laboratory experiments, PYR01 showed a remarkable ability to kill HIV-1 infected cells without harming uninfected cells. So if you had a pool of CD4 T cells and some of them were infected, these molecules, PYR01, would work only on the infected cells because only there it would find HIV genes so that the related protein can be synthesized. PYR01 worked by accelerating the dimerization of the reverse transcriptase enzyme, a critical step in the HIV life cycle, and this premature dimerization set off a cascade of events resulting in the formation of an inflammasome and the destruction of the infected cell. Remarkably, PYR01's effectiveness wasn't hampered by common NNRTI resistance mutations, a significant advantage over existing therapies. Despite the promising results, many questions remained. Could PYR01 and other TAC drugs safely and effectively reach and eliminate the latent HIV reservoirs in the patients? Would they exhibit any adverse side effects similar to those seen with efavirenz, such as neuropsychiatric symptoms? Those are all the questions that remain. The Merck team was optimistic yet cautious. They knew that translating these findings from the lab to clinical settings required rigorous testing and validation. However, the potential was undeniable. TAC drugs like PYR01 could be used alongside conventional ART, not only suppressing HIV replication, but also progressively reducing the reservoir of infected cells. The fight against HIV was far from over, but with TAC, they had a potent new weapon in their arsenal. So I'm going to be following what happens with PYR01 and TAC class of therapies, and I'll bring more information to you as we proceed. But right now, this is all I got, and I hope this is inspiring you, and this fills you with hope for a new drug that can help you in your quest to get rid of HIV. Please let me know what you think of this new format and how I'm approaching it. I'm thinking that I'll do a story format, then I'll do a question and answer session with Maha on the same topic so that it's very, very clear and you're able to get a full understanding of what this therapy is. Also, I've noticed that we are crossed 15,000 subscribers, so it's all due to your support. So thanks a lot, my friends. And in case you have been a subscriber for a while, can you please consider becoming a member to join our monthly once-in-a-month Zoom session, which is interactive. You can see me, I can see you, you can ask me questions, and I can answer back to you. So it's a dynamic interaction. It happens once a month. And if more people join, I could consider doing it more often. So I'm looking forward to you joining me in the next Zoom session, which will happen next month. So you have plenty of time right now. Just get in there. And you also get early release of videos if you become a member. So that's again another benefit. So I'm hoping that more members will join and we can have a great Zoom session. So that's all for today. I'll be back with a Q&A session on TAC with Maha. And watch out for that video. Bye for now. I'll catch up again with you in the next video. Adios.